Are you tired of seeing the great gap between us, beginner CapCut users, and advanced video editors? In this guide, I'm going to give you 10 tips to instantly level up your editing on CapCut and get out of the newbie zone. First 6 tips will be related to visuals and graphic editing, such as VFX and some amazing transitions and effects. Last 4 tips will talk about some important audio editing tips that I wish I knew when I started. We'll cover some important stuff, like music sync, audio effects, and lip sync. Let's get into it. So first up in the graphic category, the use of VFX. These things can really spice up your content and give it a fresh and engaging look. It can either be to highlight something, or to add motion to your video, or to use in a transition. Of course, you have to use them moderately. There are plenty of sites where you can download them. You got the major paid subscription sites, like Motion Array or Envato Elements. But since I'm not going to be producing action movies, probably neither are you, there are some good free alternatives. You have actionvfx.com. It has some nice and free video effects you can put your hands on. There is also fxelements.com. They also have some nice free VFX. But my personal favorite is footagecrate.com. Good quality and varied video effects. Cartoon, fire, smoke, water, and so on. The only downside is they limit to 5 free downloads per day, and the free ones are more rare than the paid ones. You can tell by this little star. What you can do is download as much as you can over time and build up your VFX library. Once you've downloaded them, all you need to do is import them into CapCut and select blend mode to screen. Place it, resize it, and sync it, and you're done. You could also go for some VFX on YouTube, on green screen. Some work fine with the chroma key, but I like those with glow on. And these don't work well with the chroma key, as you can see. And the blend mode does not work properly on green screen either. So that's why I like to stick to high-resolution black screen effects. Tip number 2. Select your transitions. What I mean by this, you have dozens of transitions at your disposal on CapCut. It can even be sometimes hard to choose between them. Well, that's exactly my point. In all those presets, there are a couple that are super underrated, and what I like about them is that they can be combined together in a series of sequences and be used along your story. I personally use exclusively the following: radial blur for major scene changes, and these camera movements: top left, left, bottom left, bottom right, right, top right. These are complete 360 degrees movement. You can add to them inhale, pull in, pull out, and infinite. And you got yourself a set of transitions to always use. I'm not saying you should use these exact ones, but at least try to have consistency in the transitions you choose to work with and make them have sense. That's not it. You can also use effects as transitions. Let me show you with an example. Let's say I want to make a transition between these two clips and I want it to be soft. There is, for example, the chroma zoom effect in the glitch section. Place it anywhere on the timeline. Try to locate where the peak of the effect is. Once you find it, trim your effect on the right side and place it at the end of the first clip, like this, then extend it back. And voila, a nice and subtle transition. Other effects can do similar things. Here is another example with the fuzzy effect. I can even stack another effect to give it this unique look. And that takes us to our next tip. Stacking effects is way overpowered. For this example, I'm going to use a multi-layer scene. Each element will be a separate asset. This way I can have different effects on each one. I got the vector image from freepik.com. If you want a tutorial on vector images, let me know in the comment section. So we go into CapCut and import our elements one by one. I'm going to start with the background, the road, the cars, and the trees. And don't forget to manage your layers on the right panel. Front objects on higher layers. And I'm gonna put some movement into it using keyframes. I'll be right back. Okay, so this is just an example, not a real animation project. Movement seems okay. All right, now we can start adding our effects. You can apply the effect on the whole sequence by placing it like this. But I'm gonna start with each object separately. Motion blur on the trees. For the cars, I'll put some camera shake and stack it with the shake effect. You can adjust different settings for each effect on the right panel. I'll also put some rain in the background. You can find it in the nature section. And to finish up, let's apply some old TV effects on the whole thing. And here is the result. You will have to try out multiple ones to get interesting results. Moving on to our next tip, something I learned too late. Using the blend mode, the one we used for the VFX, for this example, go ahead and select a good-looking clip. Place a black background on top of it, then a text block. Make sure the font is large and big. Select the text and the black background and create a compound clip. Now you can scroll down the blend modes and see the different results. Yes, some catch our attention. Let's take one of them and play with the size using keyframes. Start with normal size and finish with maximum size. And here is the result you can get. Tip number 6. Use speed curves for your clips. To shorten it, or simply to give it some spice, you can head on to the Speed tab and choose one of the presets over here. I prefer to use the bullet preset and adapt it to my scene. Change the cursor's position to adjust the speed of each segment. Here is the result. You can play around with those handles until you get the effect you like for your scene. Okay, now the audio editing tips. I've been wanting to share these for a while now. They're absolute game changers. First up, how to sync your music into the content. You know, how sometimes some moments in your video should be aligned with a moment in the music, like this? Yes, your music contains some key moments, like an instrument coming in, or a change of rhythm, or simply a beat. To align them with a key moment in your video, very simple. Locate a key moment in the music that would go well. These spikes over here can be very useful. Trim it on one of the sides, then go locate the key moment in the video. For this example, the key moment is when the lion appears on the screen. Place the music at that timestamp and extend it. And here is the result. If you have a sequence preceding it, and you fear for the audio mix, you can always try to stack some sound effects to do a nice audio transition. In this example, I'll add a drum sound and an impactful movement sound, and make sure to align the peaks properly. This is just an example. I picked random clips and music, and here is the result. And what we used here is our tip number 8. Audio effects can also be stacked. In the previous example, we combined the drum sound with a movement sound. Together, it gives this. Now we could have done it instead with an explosion sound, for example, which would have given us this. So, play around with stacking complementary sound effects to create unique ones. Moving on to tip number 9, and that's the use of built-in voice changers in CapCut. There are lots of interesting ones. You can go to the Voice Changer tab and choose among the presets depending on your scene. It could be someone talking in a microphone in a large conference room,
or a protester shouting in his megaphone.
Or it could be the echo effect to depict a scene of someone remembering something or thinking of something. But I think it's also interesting to use it on music. For this example, I'll take a clip of a girl dancing in a nightclub and a clip of a guy getting into his car in the parking lot. Put the music track and split it at the transition. On the second one, apply the deep effect, adjust the volumes, and here's the result. And now to my favorite tip, how to do lip sync. You know, when you want a voice to match exactly another character speaking, in a movie scene, for example, or even your own AI avatar. Let's take this example. So this clip is animated from this image. Using artflow.com, I animated this character to say this.
We'll cover some important stuff, like music sync, audio effects, and lip sync.
The output is made using one of the AI voices from Artflow. If you want to change the background, simply select the Auto Cut feature and use a mask on your character if there are still unwanted elements. Then put the background, your voice, align everything. We'll cover some important stuff, like music sync, audio effects, and lip sync. But there's a problem. You can clearly see lips and audio are not synced. The key to solve this is to cut into consistent segments using these peaks. Every up and down matches a word or a syllable. So you want to split both your audio and video following these highs and lows. The goal is to end up with segments aligned as much as possible in front of each other. What you need to remember. On a video clip, trim only extremities. Never trim any part inside the video clip. Always try to cut the segments where the silences are, right in the middle. Don't cut if it's incomplete silence, like here. You can turn the volume up to better see the signal. and use exclusively the speed changer to adjust the segments. On the audio clip, never change the speed. But you can remove complete silences from inside your sequence if it helps you align the words better. Trim the start and end of your video clip, then mirror each segment using the speed changer. Every word or syllable should be mirroring each other on the clip and the audio. At the end, you go from this. We'll cover some important stuff, like music sync, audio effects, and lip sync. To this. We'll cover some important stuff, like music sync, audio effects, and lip sync. And this is not a complete tutorial on character animation. It would take way longer to cover everything. Anyway, those were my 10 CapCut tips for today. Hope they'll be useful to you. If you like them, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And give us your thoughts in the comment section. Cheers.